Hey folks, this is Farmer Rambler, and welcome to another episode of Farming Simulator 17. I was rolling it forward till tomorrow morning to start the episode, and so we're about 3 in the morning right now, when the weather symbol changed. You can see up there, I'm thinking that's hail. I don't think it's snow. Snow doesn't happen unless you have a special mod. But it's not the symbol that I'm used to for rain. Usually those are straight lines coming down. So, we've got a storm rolling in, apparently. And it's going to be a doozy. So, what crops do we have going? Let me speed it back up again. I just wanted to make sure to record this while it was, in case the weather did change on me. But I put plant... You can hear the wind. Plant growth back up to normal. So that we can get the grass mode over there this episode. It should be hitting right about now. The beets over there just went to their second stage of growth, or third stage. Yeah, so next stage will be harvest. These guys, we put in the oilseed radish. These can be started be cultivated back in again. And even though it's dark right now, I guess we go ahead and get started on that. We'll keep it at 15 speed right now, so we'll get to daylight here pretty soon, but yeah, I'm sure we'll find someone that can be willing to do the job there. Yeah, we'll do it ourselves. It is 3 in the morning. What crazy person's going to go farming at 3 in the morning? So let's hop into here and we'll grab the big cultivator. We'll run all the lights. Haha, I'll just do the front one for now. And let's get inside, or it's a little bit quieter. Turn my speakers down a little bit. How's my DPI? I'm gonna go up one faster. Woohoo! There we go. And so 3:20 in the morning. Let's grab the cultivator. Yeah, we couldn't sleep. Just needed to go out and get this done. Got a storm coming in, so we got to deal with this. But we've got the oilseed radish in these two. We've got beets, which are in the dirt over there, just the tops. And when they're done, you take the tops off anyway. So we really don't have any crops that would be harmed by hail, if that does turn out to be it. I've not seen this symbol before, so this one's new to me. Where's my center? It's that guy right there. Something like that. Can I grab that? Yeah. So this is the oilseed radish, which means we can cultivate it right back in. And it becomes a fertilizer. Yeah, let's... More of this side over here. Okay, what are we looking like? Move down, let's go to that one. And off we go. So this guy... Running at 7. We're going slightly uphill. It might hit 8 eventually. I'll go ahead and trigger the cruise control there and do that. We're at 339. Let's see... clouds haven't really changed yet. So, that's usually the weather, or the position for the symbol for the weather that's current. So I guess it's still giving us an hour's warning. Oh, it's slowed down to 3. There we go. Oh, I see. I hit cruise control again, and it stayed at 6. So let's... Let me up that up. Let's see, 2. Take it up to about 10. Okay. So that one and that one. So I'm taking a chance here, hitting every other row that we're going to hit them evenly. Yeah, I should probably take this every row. Coming up on 4 o'clock. Yeah, we definitely have something coming in from over there. We'll see. Yeah, that wasn't the best way to do that. I guess I got hit every row. Well, we'll catch one side, then come back and clean up the other. Okay, well, I'll speed up time a little more then. I was assuming it was going to come in here pretty fast. I'm floored. This guy just rides at 6 miles an hour. Now I know. That's the cultivator speed. No, nothing ominous out there yet. Maybe sunrise is one little trigger. Sunrise is at 5, and I was planning on starting the game over there at the chickens at 5 o'clock. That didn't happen. Back later and catch those last little spots there. Well, I guess that wasn't as dramatic as I was expecting. Go ahead and take that back down to 5 speed there, and we'll just get our day started. I think at 6 a.m. would be acceptable to assume that we'd find someone to hire out. We'll often do other things. I think I missed a spot there. There we go. Now we're hitting 9 miles an hour. Interesting. So it really is feeling it going up the hill. I was hitting 6 there. I guess I was hitting more like 3 or 4 at the very end. That's nice to see. You really noticed it back in the 2015 version of this game. I hadn't noticed it much in this one, though there's not a lot of hills in this map. So don't have a lot of inclines. Any of you ever hear of Westbridge Hills being remade for 2017, let me know. I would like to play that one again. Now what's with that spot right there? Just wondering if the cultivator missed it or if it just didn't get fertilized once. Maybe that's what that is. I think I'll do is I'll go ahead and catch these couple of little spots here and then hire the rest of this out. The hired hands do such straighter rows, you know, more straight than I do. Okay. Let's catch this one this way. Whoa. Alright, this is the tractor that loves to go extreme on its turns. There we go. So that button, and I want to drift over and see what's with this. Yeah, let's do it this way. It'll cultivate diagonally if you pull it diagonally. Now, what is with that spot? Is it still there? Nope, it's not. So let's see here. The other way. Okay, let's go over here. Nope, that spot's gone too. Okay. Let's hire that out. We're after 5 in the morning. We'll call that good enough. Hire, jump off, and you just have a ball. Okay, let's go get our chicken eggs. We'll drive into town, and this time we'll figure out where those things sell at. Where am I at? Chickens are this way. I'll run through the barn here. I don't know if you've ever been in here. There's a bunch of hay piled up. Okay, try not to step on any chickens. At nighttime, they're silent. They just roost down in the grass and hide from foxes. Alright, that all of them? Nothing in the bowl? No. Okay. Too bad you can't go through the house. I'll never know what my farmhouse looks like inside. I'm the farmer that never sleeps. Alright, let's go drop this off. And take a little detour and see what the beets look like. So this is the final stage of growth. Huh, I thought they'd be a little taller than that. Growth. No, I think that there is one more stage. Okay, so it'll be next time that we put out the $100,000 for all that equipment. Okay, let's go sell our eggs. They better be worth a lot. We've got equipment to buy. Let's get in cab. There we go. 35 on this road. See if we can find the spot where you sell the eggs. Gonna go over to Mabel's house. Oh? What are we seeing there? Interesting. Is that a glitch? No, I didn't want to do that. Shift tab. I wanted to do this. That is 24 cultivated. The game did go through. These were dead. These were withered. Did a bad job. Although that doesn't look withered. Like that does. No, I think this one was harvested. That happened over there too, so it's gone through its next stage and it's about to go through and be processed again, but we didn't get those. Interesting. Well, now I know. Probably gonna have to do those all manually. Alright, let's wander back and forth through town and find this spot. As far as I know, there's only one on this map. Oh, that's right, it's 50 in here. Now it's 25. So, not this one. Let's try this one. We'll just wander back and forth. Like a creepy old guy trying to find a spot to sell his eggs. not over there. What's over here? Nope. This is where you sell to the bakery. Must be on the other side of the, whatever that is, at the river there? I think the river's in there. Yeah, there's a bridge. All right, I've got eggs to sell. Anybody? Not there. Ooh, that looks familiar. Anybody over here buy my eggs? I bet you'll buy my eggs. There we go. How many eggs will you buy? $538 worth of eggs. Wow, I have a lot in my backpack. You just have to go to the secret gray door over here. Next to the red barrels. Yeah. What is that place in the front? I can't sneak through, can I? Yeah, I'll get totally stuck. Okay, let's drive around. Let's see, which one is he? 1, 2, 3 in from that end. Okay, between the red top and the red metal roof there. Let's see what that is. What kind of a place has a secret egg drop-off point at their back door? Where the egg dealers go in to get their stuff. All right. Waffles. Ha ha, that explains it. Waffles will buy it. Yeah. Okay, I'll go around the block. Let's get back in the cab. There we go. And home is where? So that's the park? No, that's the park's over there. Okay. Hope that wasn't a stop sign. We live right over there. So what to do? We're still two stages. Well, stage and a half from harvesting the beets. Let's pop over to the grass farm. Grass field. The meadow. We'll call it the meadow. Ah, that's looking promising. There we go. Yep, you can see where the field edge used to be. There is like a couple of feet there of dead zone. Otherwise, half of it's ready to mow and the other half is not. Okay, well, we're making progress here. Helper D has finished their task. Let's get Helper D working on the other one. Get seeds picked out for these fields and get them planted. Just realized it never rained or hailed. Huh. What if it treats it as a chance for hail rather than it will hail? I don't know. I see green. No, I saw from a distance and it changed. Okay. Underneath the cultivator was green, but it went away. Looks like we got everything. I don't see anything else over there. Let's go put this away. There we go. Ah, he left his lights on. I'm gonna wear down a battery doing that. Alright, we're in the air. We are. Let's run up here. Get him started on this one. And what crops do we want? Really what it comes down to is what can we afford to harvest? We could do more sweet potatoes. We're going to have the equipment. Should we do a major sweet potato haul? We're going to be burnt out on topping sweet potatoes, aren't we? Sweet potatoes. No, I did it again. Beets. Sugar beets, not sweet potatoes. So beets. Only 200 something per something. Per 1,000 liters? Don't know. But if it's anything like the potatoes, you get huge quantities of, huge yields. That's why I consider these all fairly even. Now, I wonder if 1 hectare of canola right there, which is quite expensive, but you get very little yield out of it, versus 1 hectare of wheat, which is half as much, but you get so much more, if it's, you know, is actually fairly even in quantity per acre when you average it all out. I suspect it's fairly even. Don't know that because it's hard to calculate what a 1 hectare is, because once you buy the field, you no longer get a pop-up that tells you how much it is. I guess you can go online and figure it out, but I can't tell you how big 12 is, whereas I could pop into these and it'll give me the specs still. Once you buy it, that little symbol right there is gone, and now you've lost your information. Let's do this then. Our quantities at this time. Corn I would love to do, but that's a new harvester. So this is a new harvester and planter, and this is a new harvester. So this is the cheapest of the two of the three possibilities to get going. That's why we chose this one. Though it's always fun to bale. Could do one of these two every time in one of these three fields. Always have something to make straw and bale out of. Kind of like that plan. It's a good, you know, break in variety. I like the way the canola looked. Let's do a canola and a barley. Yep, I think that's the answer. So we got him going over there. What else are we going to be doing? What tractors do we use? The little guy should do the little sower just fine. Let's jump in here. Just bump my pedals. There we go. Let's get the little sower in this one. Get one crop going into field 15, which is smaller than the other one. Seems like we topped him off last time when we parked him. Looks topped off. Yep. Oh, ceilings. Drive me nuts. Alright, so this guy goes to the little one. And let's put canola up there. We'll make this one the barley this time. Like so. Now, see if I can remember. I? Nope. Y. There it is. Y. Wheat. Barley. Higher. Eject. Yep, it's counting to the edge. Okay. And let's grab a little bigger tractor. And get the bigger sower on him. This guy right here. We have fuel in this one. I think we filled up the New Holland as well, the blue one. Now we gotta check the seed and fertilizer level on this one. Yeah, we could use both. Let's see. I'm into that wall right there. Okay. Still into the wall. There we go. That was a little close. Let's see. I'm going to hop in the cab and do this. I think. There we go. Nope. When you don't do this for several days. Alright, we should get those lids to pop up, right? There we go. And this time I'm not going to be fooled by that. It means we just got rid of a container. Interesting, it's still floating up there. Let's back up some more. There's the lids up again. Once we pop the the last lower one up there. I wonder if the top ones are going to topple forward. Okay, fill that one up, and we're done. Okay. Now do the same with fertilizer. There it is. Blocked by an object. What did we do wrong? I started the sower down here at this end so he wouldn't conflict with the one up there. Oh, that was the sower, wasn't it? Pop out of here. Yep, he's stuck up there. Interesting. It just cannot handle that corner anymore. Okay, this one is going to be... Oh, I gotta unfold this. Canola.
That's right.
So, why? I passed it, didn't I? Canola. There's no canola on this one. Wait a minute here. Corn. Beet. Sunflower and soy. I guess we're doing soy. Okay, answered that one. Okay. Line myself up better so that he starts off correctly. And we're on soy. Okay. Do that. Let's get this guy out of the garage. Where's he at? Okay, he's outside. And doesn't look like he's moving, but I think he is. There we go. I was moving as fast as him, so it made him look like he stood still. All right. What's your problem? Oh, you're stuck good. Let's see here. There we go. Yep, just need a little help there. Yeah, looks good. Okay. So, cultivating, sowing, and storm never came. Yep, those weathermen, I tell you. So, what are we going to do then? I guess we can go and begin... Well, we can do two things. We can either begin mowing over there, or we can go get the equipment for the beets in that field, which has got to be done probably this game day. I think this tractor can bring it all back. I don't know if it can run it all, but I'm sure it can bring it back. No, I need 2 3-point hitches. So we're stuck waiting for him. And I can't mow until we get him, too. Okay. Then what? Harvester needs to be fueled up. Let's spend a little time gassing up vehicles. We'll bring the gas to the harvester. Much faster. Let's see, we dropped him off from this direction. Notice there's a little fuel symbol on the bottom of the little menu there in the bottom right. I could fuel myself up right now. It's close enough to do it. Let's do that. All right, so R, fills him up. Turn him off and jump out. I'm stuck. Jump into him. R. Didn't. After we started? No. Let's see, where am I over here? I'm seriously not close enough? There it is. Okay. There we go. Wish I'd come close to emptying that fuel tank. It wasn't that big, and we've done a lot of fill-ups with it, so head out to a gas station. We'll go to the northern station this time. Boy, this camera jumps you with every post you cross through. Huh. Okay, this guy's full. Turn him off. Jump out. Grab this guy. New. Try that again. Go to this side. And 180 gallons left in this. Now, these trailers with a short little neck are pretty unforgiving. They start to get out of sync and they usually don't recover. So, all the rest of them are busy. And we don't have anything else that takes fuel. We have 4 tractors and a harvester. And a pickup. Let's hook this up to the pickup. Drive out there and get some gas. By then, the cultivator should be done, then we can get to work doing other things. Where is that little hitch symbol? There it is. Okay, and I can fill this one up too while I'm at it, so let's get that done. Alright, now, I'm heading up the road past field 9, 5, 4, and between 3 and 4. Okay, I know where I'm going. Yep, the storm that never materialized. This would have been quite a different beginning to this episode if that symbol hadn't shown up. I'd have been standing there amongst all the clucking chickens. Boy, the floorboards in this truck are dirty. Alright, that was 5. There's 4. And there's the gas station. Now, can I just skirt along the front here? Yeah, we'll do that. And we'll take up the whole bay. Alright. R. Now fill her up, please. Thousand gallons. Didn't tell me what that cost. Don't want to know. Whoa. If you just go by really slow, it never hits. Ah, there it is, $1,300. Do have a car this time. I probably should wait. He's bigger than me. Well, not much bigger. Boy, big difference. Take me a long time to get up to speed now. I got some weight behind me. Now, it's not this one. This takes you across the top of the map and over to the sawmill at the other end, the biogas plant. We want the one that's one block down, one country block down. Okay, so let's think about where this is going to go. I'm actually kind of wondering about just right here in the end cap. Something like that. That'll work. Let's see how this is going. Looks like he's almost done. That'll work out fine. Well, while we're waiting, let me get over here where it's not too noisy. Because he's going to come driving by soon. At least I hope he is. Let's take a peek at our store catalog. Cultivators. I want beet harvesting. There we go. So we're looking at 17 and 88. And Klaus was suggesting that we take another look at these guys. He's saying 1 and 3. You can pile the sugar beets onto the ground because the harvester fills up so fast, and then set this guy into the pile, dumping onto this guy, which dumps into your trailer. It's an idea. Though we could do it just like we've been doing. Here's a hopper version. Fill up the hopper, and that dumps... I don't know, one of these days when we're rich, we've got to buy all these and just set them all up and play with them, see what they do. I'm used to just bringing the trailer by. We've got trailers low enough that beets. This guy, where does he dump? I'm trying to see the... Well, on this guy, it's right over here. So let's say it's right over here, too. It's not very tall, so you can't use the tallest trailers, if I recall. But we don't own the tallest trailers right now, so it would still function just fine. It might behoove us to hire this part out and follow behind with this one, rather than running both on the same tractor. Whenever you make turns, you always miss a triangle at every turn with this setup. Because this guy is still, it's on a pivot, so it's still swiveling off to one side as you're completing your turn pulling in, and you miss a little bit each time. So if I had to hire someone to do this, we can take our time and hit the rows evenly. Well, these do need to be bought, so may as well get that done. Buy you. Buy you. No options. And we'll call that good there at $70,000 left. See, that $1 million did not last long. Okay, he just got finished. And we're done with this one. Yeah. Fold you up. Let's go do something we haven't done before. Let's give this thing a bath. He's needing it. Take a little pride in our plow. I like all the noises that Massey Ferguson makes when it turns off. Alright, yep. This thing's been playing in the dirt. Haven't seen it shiny red since we bought it. Much better. This one wasn't so bad. Just get the windows a little bit. Okay. Let's put him away. Yeah, that one failed from the beginning. But I'll get them halfway there. Alright, let's pull out and do that one again. There we go. That's much better. Alright, well, let's go get some equipment. Don't think either of these guys can fail in their pathing, so don't need to be here to reset them. So we get that equipment, and then, as far as I know, there's nothing more to do except mow some grass and get that process started. And continue until the beets are ready to harvest. Why is this guy driving with his brake lights on? Oh, his headlights are on. Right, normally we take the back road, but this time we're not. Whoa, we're going to take the sidewalk instead. This Massey Ferguson steers so different from all the rest of them. When you're accelerating, I think, is when it happens. The acceleration exaggerates the turn. I notice if I let off in the accelerator, then make my turn, it responds pretty quickly. But accelerating just kind of grips the steering wheel and won't let it release. Odd how it's hard to describe. You just got to feel it. It feels different from all the rest of them. Which is kind of nice, in a sense, that when, you know, in a game where you're just steering with two buttons, you can actually tell the difference between the two, or between the pieces of equipment. That you can program that into two buttons, you know? Alright, so little guy on the front, I didn't notice where the connection was. Probably not this side. Well, it is. But the front, yeah, so this way. What's behind me? Alrighty, now this guy from the back. It is good that they don't have traffic turned on for the parking lot here. This would really be tough, dealing with cars. Okay. Hook him up. Let's see what we've got. So this guy goes through and tears all the tops off of the beets. Shreds it all up, throws it on the ground. And then this guy over here digs them up, flips them into, I guess, that auger, which then throws it down underneath, and all the dirt drops through the baskets, tosses into this guy, which goes up over the top and drops it in. And I think this may be where it leaves? I guess we'll find out. One of these guys swings out and dumps. Okay. We'll drop all this stuff off, and I guess this will live up next to the harvester, the combine. So we'll park this one permanently. Clear and clear. I saw Night Ghost playing Astroneer the other day. He's got a Let's Play series on it, so I watched those. He was playing it, I think, on one of his live streams once, too. And you're not going to turn from me, are you? Good. And that's kind of a fun game. It's pre-alpha, so there's a lot more they've got to add to the game, and there's lots of little quirky glitches here and there, but I went ahead and bought it, impulse buy, and right about New Year's. And he noticed on my Steam channel that I was playing it and got in touch with me and said, "Hey, you want a multiplayer?" So I jumped on with him, and the multiplayer is really glitchy. Yeah, I was driving the little truck around, and suddenly it flipped into the air and flipped over and then separated into pieces, and he drove over to help me, and he says, "Oh, it looks normal to him." And then one time the truck just flipped and threw me clear up into the clouds, and then slowly dropped all the way back down to the planet and crashed. Kind of like, you ever play Skyrim and get on the wrong end of a giant's club, and they actually shoot you all the way up into the clouds, and you'd fall straight down to the ground? Well, that's what this did to me, and it's not supposed to, so lots of glitches yet. All right, G back there, Q, and let's just do a 90 degree, and V, and Q. All right, you're done. That's all ready to reload. And we're coming up on 50 minutes. I'm thinking let's get this all set up and ready to mow next episode. Now that's all on that front right there. What else do we want to bring over there? The round baler is over there. Let's grab the... let's grab the wind rower. We'll bring that set up over there. We'll do that for a little while, then we'll bring the tedder for another section. We'll do that for a while. Now I'm on the right direction, right? Yeah, I think I am. Okay. Hook you up. Wow. Front of the tractor just dipped down there. Neat. So we go up the center, curve at the last second. Try to keep that from dragging into that one. Looks okay. All right, so let's head up to 11. So, if it's possible, I may try to do a series in the Astroneer, maybe when we get towards summer. That will give the developers a chance to add some more content to it and fix a few more bugs. Hate to start a game on a series on a pre-alpha game that might have some major updates coming that are save breakers, so that you go to your save file to find you can't continue your series anymore because the next update crashed it. That's why I'm still on Alpha 13 for RimWorld. Each alpha that comes out, you've got to start over. You can't, they won't talk to each other. And luckily, I'm not doing that RimWorld series for the content of the alpha. I'm doing it for the soap opera of the game itself, so I don't have to be in the most current version to have just as much fun. Alright, so I'm thinking we're going to split this field right up the middle. Let me get out here. Or do we just do the little leg over there? Remember how this is laid out. What should we do here? I want to do hay. I want to do straw. I want to do silage. So we need to probably windrow, cut and windrow all of it. Then we can bring the tedder out and mess up a few of those rows to make hay bales. Look at the, it's kind of a foggy, misty morning look to it. I wonder if the weather is about to change now. I wonder if it was like a 6-hour warning. It was 3 in the morning, and now it's changing. I bet you it's gonna hit us for next episode. I'm going to park that right there. Let's move it forward a little bit, just in case someone else wanted to use that road. Right there. And I think we're going to stop it here, because I have a feeling we got a big change coming here in a moment. And I want to see that happen. So let's call this one done. This is the Noble Rambler. Thanks, guys, for watching. I'll catch you next time. Bye-bye.